The More in Minutes video series gives you quick tips for getting more out of the SAP Concur solutions you already have, so you can bring more value back to the business and more time back in your day. In this video, we're going to look at three simple ways to make managing vendors and invoice processing easier with Concur Invoice. You've invested in Concur Invoice to bring clarity, confidence, and control to your AP process. But once your solution is up and running, it's easy to fall into a routine and overlook simple features and functionality that can help you save precious time. Let's start with our first tip. Coding invoices is a necessary part of every AP process, a step we all know has to get done, but we also know takes a bit of time. Did you know that in Concur Invoice, you can set default expense types for individual vendors? So, for example, every invoice from a company like Staples is always coded to office supplies. Of course, this coding isn't set in stone. It can be changed by you or other users if appropriate. But by setting the most common or most likely expense types for a given vendor as the default, you can increase the accuracy of how invoices are coded and save a few precious moments with each invoice, moments that can add up quickly when you multiply them across every invoice you process. And setting up these defaults is quick and easy. Here's how it works. Under the Vendor Manager tab, select Manage Default Expense Type. Then select the vendor and hit the Assign Default Expense Type button. A predefined list of expense types pops up, and you simply select the right expense type. Hit Assign, and you're good to go. Now, every invoice that rolls in from that vendor will be coded to that expense type. Okay, next, let's talk about a similar concept, vendor mapping. In this case, though, instead of applying a default expense type to a vendor's invoices, we create a default approver. So every invoice that comes in will go to one person you set as the approver. So why would you want to set up a vendor with a default approver? Imagine if you want to have oversight into all the hardware your organization is purchasing, like phones and laptops. So you make sure that every invoice from your preferred hardware vendor gets sent to the right person in IT. Vendor mapping makes sense when one manager owns the budget and needs to keep tabs on the spending, adding an extra layer of consistency and control to the process. How does this work? Well, go back to the Vendor Manager tab, select Vendor Mapping List, and choose the vendor by clicking the checkbox. Then select Assign Default Invoice Owner. The Employee Helper pop-up will appear, and you can simply type in the name of the invoice owner you would like to choose, and select Assign. Then you're all set. Now, all of that vendor's invoices will get sent to the same approver, adding that extra layer of oversight and much-needed consistency. Keep in mind how these routing options are used will depend on your business's specific configuration. Connect with your SAP Concur representative to talk through any scenarios that may be specific to your company. Now for our last tip. Let's move away from approvals and coding and talk about keeping a clean vendor list in your solution. As you and your team are reviewing, coding, and approving invoices, any extra information in the system can slow you down. That's why when we work through implementation, we try to make sure we start with a clean vendor list as possible, removing any old, inaccurate vendors from your system. But what happens if, after you're up and running with Concur Invoice, your vendor goes out of business, or you simply stop buying what they're selling? You don't really want to delete them from your system, because what if an old invoice rolls in, or what if you start working with them again? Plus, if you delete the vendor, you lose all your history with that vendor. But you can inactivate them to clear them out of the vendor list the average user sees without clearing them out of your system altogether. Let me show you how this works. Go back to the Vendor Manager tab, select Manage Vendors, choose the vendor to inactivate, and under the Actions menu, select Inactivate. Now the vendor is out of the way, but not out of the system. And reactivating a vendor is just as easy. From the same Manage Vendor tab, select Inactive Vendors from the View dropdown. Now you see all the inactive vendors, and you simply select the vendor you want to activate, and under the Actions menu, choose Activate, and the vendor is back on the active list. Coding, routing, and approving invoices is a necessary but time-consuming process. You've already automated it with Concur Invoice, and these simple tips can add more simplicity, more control, and more clarity to the process you have in place.